The time allowed is 84 seconds, and away we go. A great crowd here this afternoon. Those seats nearly full, they certainly will be by the time we get underway with a few horses gone. We start off with the Argentinian rider. He's been going well this week, Jose Maria La Roca. And he's ridden in the World Equestrian Games in 2006. And he rode this horse as an individual in the last Olympic Games in Hong Kong. 43-year-old Jose Maria. Capable rider, been around a fair while now. He used to live in Britain, actually, right over here. But now he lives in Geneva, in Switzerland. Let's have a look at this course. Moderate first fence, but that's where that ends, because straight on down here, now a very wide triple bar. 5 strides, ditch towards, 1 stride and a ditch on the landing side. Now, what are they going to do here? Some horses will go 5 strides there. It's a very similar distance to the one we had in the first round here on Monday. But I think the majority of horses will go on 4 strides there. It's a very tall and light 160 vertical there. Serpentine line up here. A very difficult line indeed. From a big vertical round the corner to a water, and then another 7 or 8 strides onto a very big ox, which he's just had down. Another 360 degree turn there. He lost his way a little bit there, lost his line. And down here, 5 strides, he comes there to that 160 plank. So, time allowed 84 seconds, as you can see, is a bit over the time there. That's 20 for the Argentina. You can see the width on that oxer. That oxer there, when I walked the course this morning, you know, I stood there with arms outstretched, and just to see how wide it was, and you can just about touch it. Well, I could just about touch both poles, arms outstretched, fingertips to fingertip. It's a very wide oxer indeed. Now, the former individual winner of this competition, a similar competition in Athens 8 years ago now, and he lost that on a disqualification, that gold medal, but won that fair and square in Athens, Ian O'Connor. Can he repeat the business here? Everybody starts today on a clean sheet. They've qualified for this individual competition over the 3 for previous legs. Saturday, Sunday, Monday. And now we're down to the top 37. But today they wipe out all the faults they've carried forward for qualification purposes. Start with a clean sheet. Over 2 rounds. 2 separate courses, very different courses, and in the event of a quality, if we get more than 1 double clear, there'll be a jump off against the clock, which normally takes place in this individual final. Kieran O'Connor jumping a good round here. Very good round indeed. This treble combination, and then 82 feet, 25 meters, straight onto the planks. He's come in 6, and jumps it, and that is a very good round indeed there for Kieran O'Connor. He's delighted with that, as he would be, because that horse has jumped a cracker. And the Irish flag there, being waved there by a supporter. And there'll be quite a lot of Irish people here to support Kieran O'Connor today. Billy Toomey, the other individual. Ireland didn't, unfortunately, have a team here, didn't qualify a team for these Olympics. And that's a superb round there for Kieran O'Connor. Michael, Robert Splane, chef to keep there. Marcus Swale there, the team vet. Brother of international rider Connor Swale. Great start for Ireland and our first clear. For Belgium, Derek de Meersman. ...48-year-old Derek, he's been around a long time now. He was fourth in Athens on that great stallion Clinton. Can hardly believe Athens, he's 8 years away. Had Beijing in between. Line there, and only about six or seven strides to it, and the water's 4.30 meters. It's big and it's flat, very flat, not a very big, little box hedge in front of it actually, but not very tall, not to get the horses up in the air. Six to the last he went, and interestingly, two fences down, a bit of time faults, nine in total. You can see what I mean there about that little brush in front of the water, but he was nowhere near jumping it, of course, as so many horses do. He put a foot back, well in, he wasn't just on the tape. And that plank, you can see there, upside down cups on that. They're on the bottom, which very flat, only about, well, 3 or 4 inches across, if that. And less than 10 centimeters and very flat. You need a very careful show jumper in international show jumping these days, and also a very capable one, scopy one. Cassio Rivetti goes next. It's Hanoverian, only a 10-year-old, Temple Road. 32-year-old Cassio. Brazilian born actually, but he joined the Ukraine team in 2009. His first Olympics. Well ridden. A section of the crowd didn't like him picking the stick up, but he was just wanting to get the horse to come off his leg a little bit more and attack that water, and it worked. He could just sense that the horse wasn't really going anywhere. A bit lucky there, but not so lucky there. His time is just tight enough, isn't it? 84 seconds. Thank you. just I wouldn't say it's all that short in there, but that was a good horse to jump that plank off that stride, a long flat stride like that. Not a fence you would have expected him to have had down. But a good round. Four gone, a 20, a 4, an 8 and a clear. Now for France. Olivier Guillon with this very good horse, Lord de Taze. Been on several Nations Cups this year and gone very well. Jumped in the European Championships in Madrid last year. 40-year-old Olivier. Young rider champion of France way back in 1993, and he's been going very strong at the top end ever since. Three riders from France, that's all they can have actually, each team, even if there's four riders qualified on points, they only take the best three of them through to this final day. This horse is jumping a super round. Interesting to see what he does to the last fence. Whether he goes forward or holds here, I think he'll stay level. Yeah, keeps coming forward on the five, and that's a lovely round there. See, this time is gettable, but they've got to keep bowling along, they've got to keep rolling. And a very good start there for France, one of the three French riders. Simon Delestre and Kevin Stout, the other two. Penelope Leprevaux didn't make it. And that's the best I've seen that horse go for a while. He was really turning himself inside out for Olivier today over this big track. Two clears. Good horse, well done. Another good horse goes next, very good horse indeed. Allerdings, owned by Hans Winkler. And ridden by Henrik von Eckermann. Henrik has been based in Germany with Ludger Beerbaum since 2004. And that would be a pretty good academy to be in, wouldn't it? Produce so many riders and horses, and it's a huge success. 31-year-old Henrik. You just can't believe how difficult that fence walks. When you walk it, you think, how are they going to ride, jump that off that distance? But as Bob Ellis said to me on Monday, you know, he said, doesn't matter what I throw at them, he said, these modern horses and on these sand surfaces that jump so well, he said, they can just jump them. Ooh, he's missed there. Unfortunately, the horse picked up a stride too soon. That wasn't rider error. He was going for the next stride. And the horse picked up one too soon. That can happen. Thankfully not too often, but not a good place to do it in the Olympic Games. Because this horse would have been on, I would have thought, for a clear round, because he's really operating today. And that's really just untucked him a little bit. It's an option there. There's an extra stride to that last one where from 4 to 5 there's no real option. They go in on the long four. It steps about a metre short of 5 really. But as Bob Ellis said, you know, they just go to the next stride, take a stride out, and these horses can jump them. Like he did, he made it look easy from 4 to 5. And it's 66 feet, 20 metres 10. But that was a proper job of the water there, and a very unfortunate mistake there. 8 anyway, for Allerdings. No permanent harm done, but an unfortunate experience which he could have done without. Now, Simon, second French rider, second of three, Simon Delestre. He was so unlucky the other day. I was talking to Hank Noren, the chef to keep, French chef to keep this morning, and I said, what happened with Simon's tack the other day? Because I said on air that I thought that the hook billet had come undone or broken. He said, yeah, that's exactly what happened. Where it folds over, where the rein joins the bit, instead of being a buckle, there's like a little loop of steel in there that the leather keeper folds over and then has a loop around it. And it just, he said, the buckle, the piece of metal in the middle that holds the bridle together just came out. It broke. Very unusual. He was as brave as a lion because he turned round, did a circle and jumped the fence. A huge oxer jumped it with no steering at all. Full marks to the man and the horse. That was an intelligent use of the corner there. It's either 6 or 7 to the water and 7 or 8 around the corner. He went wide around the corner to the big oxer. Got the 8th stride, got a good line to it. And opts to go for the extra stride down there. That's a good round. Just the one down inside the time. So 2 gone for France, a clear and a 4. We've got, 2, we've 7 gone and we've got 2 clears already. So that's, it's very early to speculate how many clears we're going to get. But that's about a third, isn't it? Just there or thereabouts. I can't see that we'll get a third of this field clear, because that would be about a dozen clears, and I'm sure Bob Ellis wouldn't have wanted that, and I think it would be unlikely, but it happened to him in the European Championships. He built an enormous course on the final day there, and in the first round he had about 13 or 14 clears. Julia Hargreaves now for Australia. 26-year-old Julia, actually born in Hong Kong, but Australian nationality, trained by George Sanner, top rider in Australia, George. She actually moved to Holland in 2011 to prepare for these games, and it's paid off because she's gone really, really well. And here she is still in there fighting on the final day, when this field is whittled down to half of what it was, or more than, less than half of what it was. Good horse this. He's a 10-year-old by Indoctro, Dutch bred. Thank you. they're certainly not clear till you've jumped the last fence or jumped this last line here, because that's unbelievable, isn't it, really, that she can jump so well all the way around there and have the last four fences down and a time fault. That's a sickener. She didn't deserve that. You know, when he hit the one rail, she'd ridden that line so well over that water and to that next fence. A little bit deep going in, but nothing wrong with the strides in the middle there. He was on his own there. That's a big gappy plank, isn't it? 160, and probably a bit with it. Luciana Dinitz, ninth to go. 41-year-old mother of twins, Luciana, Brazilian-born. Born to be a rider. Her mother was a very good rider, but a dressage champion, actually, eight times. And both her brothers are top polo players in Brazil. Won the Arkham Grand Prix. You don't do that by accident. A very capable rider. I like this horse. I've seen a lot of him. He never jumps a bad round. Look how he tried to jump that. She fired him at it on the four strides, and it is a long way on four, but too short for five. And he just picked up and gave it a foot, didn't he? Really tried to jump it. Now this vicious line across here. Six to the water. Seven to the Oxer. That's exactly what the course designers had planned. But you've got to get the line absolutely right. 160 this vertical, big vertical. And now this difficult combination and last fence. Hold him. Oh, beautifully done. Beautifully ridden. Luciana just gets better and better and better every year. She's got two very good horses. I love this horse. I think he's a real stylist, and he's got a real good attitude, hasn't he? You know, ears always forward, always a big smile on his face, saying, what do you want me to do? Okay, I'll jump that for you. And her other horse is just the same, Winning Mood, the big grey Darko horse. He's a superstar as well. And that's our third clear. He didn't breathe on a rail all the way around there then. Look at him looking for that next fence. Turns the corner and away he goes again. All Belgium. Second Belgium rider. Gregory Watherley, 10-year-old mare, Zangerside bred by Cannabis Zed. Jumped the winning round, actually, in the first of the Nations Cups this summer in La Balle, the FEI Nations Cup series, 8 Nations Cups. This side of the Atlantic, that is, European side. Those water jump judges are going to be pretty busy today, I would think. And the water isn't in the second course. There's plenty of other stuff that is. Very wide oxer going in there. Very wide, and a very wide oxer coming out. And a real half stride to that plank. It's five or six. Really, they've got to make up their mind which way they're going to go to jump that plank, but they've got to jump that treble combination before they start thinking about that. 12 for Gregory Watherley. Is so far. An unfortunate time fault there for Luciana. That could be costly. But everyone's aware of the time, but that could cost her. You don't want a time fault in a competition like, you don't want a time fault any time, but especially in a competition like this. The Japanese contingent there, I don't know whether they're Taizo's family or not, but more than likely. As I was saying, you know, when you've got two rounds here and the scores are put together, that time fault is for sure going to stop her getting, stop Luciana, and it's getting into the jump off. Because there'll be a jump off, that's for sure, with two clears already. And they're jumping it. Some and some, aren't they, really? Some horses are jumping it very well indeed, and other horses, we've got a couple of cricket scores. A bit spooky there. There's a lot of water under those fences. Horses shouldn't really take any notice of water, not at this level. But he's a bit of a sharp horse anyway. He wouldn't be just the easiest of rides. Bit of help there from Taizo, very well ridden. He's by Animo, this horse. Quite a few faults, but I think the man gave him a very good ride indeed, because Avenzio was not that easy this morning. It's a bit naughty, wasn't it? That's an interesting shot of the water there, and an interesting line to it, and an enterprising bit of riding by the Japanese rider. Got a lot of experience, Taizo Sugitani. Been around a long time, good rider. Now, here's a clear round prospect. McLean Ward, with this very good horse, Antares. 12-year-old, he hasn't been with McLean that long. year or two, but not for years and years. He certainly needed one as good as this to take over from his great mare, Sapphire. Strides here. Six, seven. Oh, he's in. And seven up there. I was just about to say McLean's in a great rhythm. This horse looks a little bit strong, and he would very nearly be in charge sometimes, but McLean's not going to let him know that. Got a hackamore and a snaffle on there, one for brakes and one for steering. That's a disappointing round there for Antares. Well inside the time. I've always thought that the way he set off McLean very much had the time in mind. But as the round progressed, I changed my mind a little bit. I think it was the horse that was in more of a hurry than McLean. Son of the great USA rider Barney Ward. That was an uncharacteristically high scoring round for McLean and this horse, but it's not an easy track, not by a long way. Still two clears, and we've gone 12 out of, started very well, two clears in the first five, and now it's fallen apart a bit. See what Lunatic can do, Jens Fredriksen. He's done his good deed for his country this summer, because at Falsterbo show, the FEI Nations Cup there, Sweden won it for the third time in 10 years, no, fourth time I think in 10 years, and it went to a three-way jump-off, and as opposed to the Olympic Games where all four members of the team go again in the jump-off as we had on Monday, in a normal Nations Cup, the chef de keep nominates one rider, and their chef nominated Jens, and he went very quick and clear and won it for Sweden on their own ground. This is a good horse. Any horse can have a rail or two round here today. There's so many opportunities to do just that. It's just big and difficult. And these fences come at you so quick. But now and again, Bob Ellis puts one of these 360 degree turns in, which can be an advantage to a lot of riders when they need to regroup a little bit, like he did then. The clock certainly will play a part. That's 8 and 1 is 9. A lot of these riders, you know, with a horse that they're just wondering whether they're going to get to the back rail, are having to ride these oxes with a lot of leg, a lot of power. See how far that back rail is off there. The horse admittedly backed off it a little bit. But it's very noticeable because of these oxes are so wide. 10 or 20 centimetres wider than they normally would be. The riders are having to fire them into these oxes and just sometimes having a front rail instead of the back, chancing the front rail to get the back, and it's not always working. Now, Rodrigo won individual gold in Athens in 2004 on the good chestnut horse Balabay. Great. Now a good stallion. Team bronze in Sydney and Atlanta. So he's no stranger to an Olympic arena, not by a long way. He's been off for quite a while, this horse, Roberto. He goes in a hackamore. It suits him. He runs on his front end a bit. Gets on his forehand. And Rodrigo is always just hauling him up a little bit, trying to get him back on his hocks, get his trajectory right. So some of these looping turns will suit him so that he can regroup. That's a brute of a water, that is. It'd be an easier water if it was on in a straight line, but it's not. Not by a long way. Nearly a right angle turn to it. Beautifully ridden round, and in fairness, a good round by the horse too. Smashing round altogether, but just that one mistake at the water. Just one down inside the time, that's another four. Well, I say another four. It's only the second four we've got. Two clears, one time fault for Luciana. Denizzi put a foot back again, didn't he? Look, he could have jumped that. Perfect stride, but it's difficult, very, very difficult to stop a horse doing that. The real good water jumpers reach out both front feet over the tape. You get one putting a foot back like that, it's very difficult to train them not to do it. As I was saying, two clears, one with a time fault, Luciana Dinitz. Rodrigo Pessoa there with four, and Simon de Lest on four, Cassio Rivetti on five. This will be the biggest track this mare's jumped. She's a smashing mare. Meredith bought her from a friend of hers. There with the bundles of jump. Great big strapping mare, isn't she? See, some horses can get to that plank on five easily enough. A big horse like this with a long stride. A lot of these horses can't get there on five, and they're opting for six. But, you know, when you're turning five into six, it's doable, really. Turning four into five, not that easy, like on from four fences four to five. Round really, but water and a pole. Eight, only just in the water, but it's enough. 33-year-old Mexican Alberto Mikan. Another mare. We've got a lot of good mares here this week. Nothing wrong with mares. If you get a good one, they really are good. They try for you. That distance from 4 to 5 is interesting, really. It's 66 feet, 20 metres 10. A long way for 4. But these horses not making it look that difficult. They're making this look difficult. She hasn't. But it's a big wide oxer to follow that water. If you get that vertical and water out of the way, that oxer grabs you. Good round, good mare, good rider, a good combination. Right, the reigning individual world champion, Eric Lamaze, won this very competition 4 years ago to the day in Hong Kong for the Beijing Olympics on the great but sadly deceased Hickstead. Jumped off, we only had two double clears on that day. He jumped off with Rolf Guren Bengston with that great little horse, Ninja La Silla. Rolf, unfortunately, not made the cut today, but Eric Lamaze has, with this good mare. Not got a lot of experience, but the man has, and he's giving her every bit of assistance. He'd love to win his medal back, his gold medal. Well, he hasn't lost it yet. He has now, possibly. Even if these two clears, of course, were the only two clears, but they won't be, but if they were, you know, they go to the next round. If they then had a fence down a piece, they're not wiping the slate clean for the next round. Two rounds added together, double clears go against the clock. Two clears so far. Kieran O'Connor for Ireland. And for France, Olivier Guillon. Good round for a novice mare, I would say. But even a rider of the calibre of Eric Lamaze would struggle to carry a greenish horse around a course of that magnitude. I think he's done it very well, and that mare will improve and improve. She's got plenty of jump. She means well, tries to jump them, but this is an old horse's track here today. Look at the width on that oxer and how they're having to ride to get the back rail and having to chance the front rails. And this terribly difficult line to this water. Now, Mr. Steele himself, Kevin Stout, former European champion, won over Bob Ellis's course. He always says he loves Bob's courses, but then he won the European Championship over them in Windsor in 2009. This man is a great rider any day of the week, any competition, anywhere, but I think he always rises to the occasion even more when he's under pressure, and on the biggest occasion it gives him a lift. When Silvana has four down, it's serious, isn't it? That wasn't unlucky, she's just had four down. It all started here. I haven't actually been keeping score of how many, there's so much to watch here. I haven't been keeping score of how many horses have been in the water, but it must be half the class so far. Don't know what Kevin said there, but not happy he wouldn't be, would he? ...51-year-old Joost Lansink from Belgium, representing Belgium. World champion, individual world champion in 2006 on the great grey horse Cavalor Camano, and team gold in 1992 for the Netherlands, Barcelona. This mare's got plenty of jump to jump this, if Joost can just keep the lid on her. Fabulous rider, this man. He's done it on so many horses for so long, at the very highest level. He couldn't wrestle with her on the way to that. There was no point trying to pull her off balance. He had to keep coming and chance it. She was towing him there. Two down. That treble combination is riding very difficult. Very, very difficult. But it is a big, it's a big treble. And wide. And then stopping dead when they get in there to jump the middle bit. And having to really explode over the back rails of those oxes. And if they run at them, run the horses at them to get the back rails, they're kicking a front rail out, as I said as well. Mm. Right, for Brazil, Alvaro. Talking about Balabé de Rue, that former ride of Rodrigo Pessoa. This is one of the many top class show jumpers by him. 12-year-old now. Alvaro, 39 now. His third Olympic Games. He was on the bronze medal winning team in Atlanta and Sydney. Like so many riders that show jump full time, he now lives in Belgium. Belgium, a very strategically placed country for European show jumping. Eric Lamaz is based there as well. The team from the Saudi Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. That's a good round, very good round indeed. Gives us our fourth on four faults, two clears, one time fault, four fours, a five, three eights. This individual final on the final day of the Olympic Games, almost invariably, there's the scores, look. That I was just talking about. No, but this final day invariably goes to a jump-off. But we'll get a few more clear rounds yet, I'm sure, but we have only got two at the moment. And they've got to do it again and go clear again after the second round. I mean, it could well be written, could be won. The way it's going, could be won on after the finish of the second round without a jump off. But let's not be too gloomy. It doesn't matter, of course, if it is won after two rounds. But a jump off's more fun, isn't it, really? Fair way to go yet. We're at 21 of 37. 16 or so to go. Steve Gerdat goes next. Interesting to see how this horse copes with it. He's a good horse. Sharp as they make them. Does it at the gallop. But this man rides him to perfection. Nino de Buissonne. Saint-Francais gelding. Dutch bred, 2001, he's 11-year-old, by Canaan. He'll have to come on the forward strides, and it'll suit him. He's gone five, look. He didn't think he could get there on the four, and this horse is going so high. Jumping out of his skin, but going so high, and he's landing steep, landing short. It helps him, actually, then, to add a stride if he wants to do, rather than landing running. Makes the wide one round the corner, wide line. Brilliant bit of riding that was. But this horse is really undoing himself to jump these fences. Now this murderous combination. Good stride. Oh, this is very good. Hold him, hold him, hold him. What a round there for Switzerland. And just more than, just a little bit less than 2 seconds inside the time. Shows how much the time takes to get, because that horse really, really travels. But that was an absolutely brilliant round there from horse and rider. Jump, Steve. He's got a great following in his own country. Bit of a pin-up boy, Steve Gerdat. And not only that, he's a very capable rider. Has been for a very long time. Although, he's only 30 now. Absolute spot on all the way. That's a bit of a relief now we've got three. Now, can this mare cope with this track? She had a bad round yesterday by her standards. Not yesterday, Monday. And had a couple of fences down, which is not unlike her, because she's jumped, as I've said so many times this week, actually. I'm going to say it again, because it's very good. She's jumped three Nations Cups and had one rail down. Two double clears and a clear and four. That's not easy to do. Irish sport horse, 10-year-old. I don't know whether you can hear on our sound effects this mare, really. Oh, he's going to have a look. He hasn't put the flag up yet. He has now. What was I saying? Love to hear this mare when she takes off. She really grunts. You can see just how much effort she puts into taking off. Well, that is so unlucky, isn't it? You've got a time fault as well, though. She's jumped a super round. Absolute super round. Just on the tape. I don't know whether we'll get another look at that. I rather hope so. Yes, we will. She went so high. Oh, just put her heel back. You could see the man went to put the... Look there. You could just see the man went to put the flag up and thought, no, I'll have another look at that. Because sometimes they give them the benefit of the doubt when they put her heel back somewhere near the tape. But that was just on the tape. She didn't deserve that. Cracking good mare, that is. Now, great reception for the first of the three riders from Great Britain. The heroes from the team jumping competition on Monday in that pulsating jump-off against the Netherlands. But that was Monday. This is today. They've got to do it all again. Clean sheet. All start on zero. Scott Brash from Scotland with this very good horse, Hello Santos. Horse that was bought for Scott to ride by Lord Harris and Lady Kirkham. With these games in mind. He looked a cheap horse on Monday. Competition hasn't fazed this young fella, has it? Giving this a peach of a ride. Now this combination, four fences from our fourth clear. On six, hold him. Oh, good man. And look at the time. Well over 4 seconds. That's given the British crowd here something to cheer about. They had plenty of opportunity to do that on Monday, and they look as if they're going to have an opportunity again today. Scott's teammates, Nick Skelton and Ben Mayer, go last but two and last but three. Absolutely. Ooh. Compare that with the previous horse. It was only just over the tape. The other horse was only just in it. Castlefield Eclipse. Fine margins, but a brilliant round there for Britain. Now, Le Mans, World Cup winner. World Cup final winner, Rich Fellers, with this Irish bred horse, flexible, 16 years of age, Irish sport horse by Cruising. Won that final in April in a jump off with Steve Gerdat, who's just jump that super clear round. Four clears now. Good, very good round. That treble combination is a bit unforgiving, would possibly be the word. It's big. Anyway, he'll be back for the other round. All is not lost. In Hong Kong, there was only two double clears then, and eight on four. Eight went against the clock for the bronze medal. BZ Madden won that on Authentic, and that was some jump off with eight horses fighting over one medal, but the gold and silver had already gone to Hickstead and Linger. Captain Canada goes next. Ian Miller. Ian in his 10th Olympics. Wouldn't surprise me to see him back for 11. He's riding as well as ever. Team Silver in 2008 and 1980. Surprisingly, I think that's might be the second time it's been down, but it hasn't been down as often as you might have thought, that flimsy little pole. very, very good round there. He'll live to fight another round. The 20 best scores, as I said earlier on, but people joining us all the way around the world. The top 20 or thereabouts go forward if there's horses tied for 18th or 19th, even though, for example, if there were six or seven on eight faults or whatever, then they would take all of them. But about the top 20 go again in the final round. Scores added together, double clears against the clock. Erka Schroeder. For Belgium, the Netherlands. ...34-year-old Herco. He rode in the Athens and Hong Kong Olympics. He's always had this games in mind for this horse since he had him as a 5-year-old. He said he'll be about good enough to go to London in 2012. So he called him London. He wasn't wrong about him being good enough, was he? These stands have filled up completely now. There would hardly be a seat available. He's got a time fault. Oh no. In a competition like this, that is as bad as a fence down nearly. Because there's only three prizes here today. There's no prize money down the line, but there's three big prizes that they're all wanting, and a time fault could well stop Erka Schroeder getting one of them. And that horse has jumped in a medal-winning style, hasn't he? What a pity. Two riders now on one fault. Erka Schroeder and Luciana Dinitz in otherwise faultless rounded. Bob there, I should think he's happy enough at the moment with four clears. Pierce next, Pierce Schwitzer. Carlina, good mare this. 11-year-old Holsteiner. Gone brilliantly this week. Ten more to go after Pierre Schwitzer. I think she's okay. Well, that's the way to do it, isn't it? Absolutely brilliant. Oh, a time fault again. Oh. You know, those three horses that have had those time faults, they don't deserve that, do they? The rounds they've jumped. And these riders, they're really having to pull out all the stops to jump that treble combination, for example. Look how short it is and how much these horses have to snap off that front rail in front and then explode and get over the back and do it three times and then come back off a short stride and jump that 160 odd plank. So flimsy to finish and then get a time fault. Oh, right, anyway, it happens. That's what the time allowed is for. The first of the three riders now. Boys are doing well, the boys from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Three in quick succession here, two together. Kamal the Hamdan, 42-year-old Kamal. It's his fifth Olympic Games, so he's no stranger to this day. This is a good mare, this is as well. He's only 11-year-old. Self-Francais, French bred by Kamano. She really tries to jump fences. Oh, oh, another one. Another one with a time fault. I don't believe it. Stanny Van Patient there, team trainer with the white shirt on. And Roger Van Eersel, the chef de keep. Ecstatic about that performance, which they should be. You would be, wouldn't you? A brilliant, brilliant round, but unfortunately, another one with a time fault, and he wasn't hanging about. You've got to hold him off some of these fences here. Got to hold him off that vertical in the middle. You can't gallop at these fences. What a mare that is. See, coming sixth to the last doesn't help. If you could trust a horse to come down there on five, or if it's got long enough stride to get there on five, it would pinch a second or two. Now Ramsey and his teammate, Ramsey Al-Dahami. It's his third Olympics. He's 40 now, Ramsey. He was one of the first Saudi Arabia riders to have a lot of success. He's always ridden in a very professional way. Years and always done a good job. It's an absolute delight to see these riders from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia getting the reward for the input they've put into show jumping over the last few years, particularly the last couple of years. What a good horse to jump that water off a long stride like that. So see on a big long striding horse you can jump that plank on five, but some horses wouldn't get there. 12. Eight more to go. This course will suit this horse. He's got jump enough. And Marcus will be well aware of the time, but he'll have to just keep travelling, because he's got to keep hold of this big fella to keep him careful. Very good horse on his day. But don't forget who's riding him. A great turn to that water, turned him in the air and landed. As soon as he landed, he was going left-handed and got him up closer to the bush on the six. Brilliant bit of riding. He says, whoa. That's a class round, isn't it? Absolute class. A brilliant round for Marcus Enning. He's one of the most rapid riders against the clock. He has a lovely way of landing and turning where he's going on that first stride. And shoo, away they go again with him. He did it into that water to perfection. That was a magic round. And our fifth clear. But 1, 2, 3, 4 on one time fault. And there it is. The cue, a bit hypothetical really, but I mean it's... sort of saying qualified for the next round yet, but they take 20. I think that takes into consideration that the next half a dozen horses are going to jump clear. A bit presumptuous the way they jump in this, but they are some very good ones. Daniel Blumen goes next for Columbia. He's been going well to be right here at the sharp end. Edwina Tops Alexander follows him. The other Saudi rider, Prince Abdullah. And then Ben Mayer, Nick Skelton, Michael van der Vleuten, and Mark Hootzager. Top class field. Best in the world. And they're jumping it like the best in the world. The ones that are really doing the business properly this morning, of which there have been a lot. only 22, Daniel Blumen. He's actually coached by Eric Lamaze. Young man with a lot of talent. And this is another very, very good mare. She's only 9, a bit young for an Olympic Games. Well, all credit to horse and rider there. That was a lovely round. Just one pole down, which he looks a little bit rueful about. But I would think he'd have to be pleased with his horse, wouldn't he? She is a smasher. And he never missed a beat all the way around there. He was absolutely spot on. But to jump that treble combination, they have got to just be tying themselves in knots and trying to the nth degree to jump it. It is a very difficult treble. Now, talking about triers, here's another one. Little Ito. Self-Francais, 16-year-old by Le Tot de Semi. Hardly any more than 15 hands high. He's not but a pony, really. But he's built like a little tank, and he doesn't know he's only 15 hands. He thinks he's 16 too. Star, isn't he? Lovely round there, just one front rail off that oxer. Edwina just shakes her head and she knows that it's all over for the medals. I don't think Four Faults is going to be good enough to get a medal here, not in this class. But she just, you have to really ride them forward to get these back rails, and of course she was going on the four strides as well, which is a very forward stride, and he just got a bit low in front, but it turned handsprings down that treble combination to jump it for her, and that's a pity, but there you go. Now His Royal Highness Prince Abdullah Al Saud has been going very, very well indeed on this Zangazide bred. He's by Carthago Z, 12-year-old Davos. Four more to come after this good grey horse. 5 clears so far, and 4 on one time fault. the moment, five faults is equal 17th. And the Sever on five. I don't think eight faults is going to make it. Arguably shouldn't do anyway. Eight falters are equal 20th at the moment. 20 go forward, and we could get another clear round or two yet. Or at least another four or two. Well, another good round there for the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. I don't think that's a bad result at all. For this really, well, you wouldn't say that it's an emerging nation any longer, because they've been around for a while, but they are really coming good with a vengeance in latter years. The riders getting more and more experienced. They've got good horses, and they're making a very good job of riding them, as they showed in the team jumping competition. A bronze medal, not bad at all. Excellent, in fact, of course. Right. A warm welcome from this crowd for one of their own, Ben Mayer. Fabulous performance on Monday as part of the British team that took the gold medals. Four men at the very top of their form and gave us a spectacle, and so did the Dutch riders in that jump off. A spectacle I think that anyone that was here or watched it would take a very long time to forget. Was a brilliant round there for Ben. That having jumped into that treble combination, excuse me, having jumped into that combination, that vertical met him very, very sharp, short. It really stopped him dead in his tracks. It was just too short for him. He went straight on. He made all the other distances easy. Pity, but that's another four. It looks very much to me as if the fours, clears, fours and fives, are going to go forward to the next round. But as we go from one British star to another one, Nick Skelton, 54-year-old Nick, held together with bolts and wire and God knows what else, broke his neck and spent months sleeping upright in a brace. New hip, new knee. He says he wants a new back now and he'll be fine. But it's not stopping him winning gold medals. And this is a superstar horse. Absolute superstar. He's won with these two great horses of the Widdersons. He's won 9 out of 12 Grand Prix on the Florida circuit. Thank you. 6. Yes, and inside the time. A world-class performance from a world-class man on a world-class horse. You can't describe it any other way. The man's a genius, and I wouldn't be the only one that thinks that. And the horse, I mean, he is a star, isn't he? What a machine. And Nick has set himself up over this last year or two to produce this horse for this one competition, the team and the individual. And so far so good. Team gold in the bag, and this is the one he wants more than ever. The one that's eluded him for so long. His sixth Olympics, and he's still on course. Six clears. Five faults at the moment is equal 19th. So I think if we get a four or clear from either of these, or five from either of these two, five faults or less from either of these two next riders, both from the Netherlands, then they've got the 20. The eights won't qualify. Michael looking down, I think the horse is all right. I think he just hit a pole and just stung himself a little bit. But with two rails down, there's no point going on, because he wouldn't, you know, he'd know that he's finished for the day anyway, that he has no chance. And there's no way that with, I don't think anyway, that with eight faults, and he'd got a long way to go too, that with eight faults that he was going to qualify for the next round anyway. And with all his efforts on Monday, jumping two rounds on consecutive days, and then the jump off as well, he might have just run out of petrol a little bit. He's a big, stuffy, heavy horse, and it's a long, long way from the opening day, the warm-up competition, to the preliminary competition, and then two rounds. It gave that a bit of a clout, you know. He could have just stung himself a little bit, but he's all right. There's Father Eric on the left, and I think you've just got to accept that the silver medals were fair game anyway. They were good enough, weren't they, for the Netherlands. But Michael's horse benefit from a week or two off now, probably. The last to go, a man that performed so well here on Monday for the silver medal winning Netherlands team. I don't quite know what they do here, because five faults is equal 19th, and then we've got 3 8s that are equal 22nd. So that's, the fives are going to qualify. I think whatever Mark Hootsager does. Twelve-year-old, this one, by Numero Uno. Dutch bred. Almost goes without saying with these lads. They breed some great horses in the Netherlands. another great round there. Look at the time. Just over half a second inside, and a great round there again for Mark Hootsager, but just one down. So there we go, let's have a look down the list now. Those six clears. Kieran O'Connor on Blue Lloyd. Olivier Guillon on Lord de Taze. Then a big long gap before we got another clear on that, and that brilliant round from Steve Gerda and Nino de Buissonnet. And then another equally brilliant round from the British rider Scott Brash. And another brilliant round from Marcus Enning. And then Nick Skelton clear. Let's see what the standings say. You can read it just as well as listen to me. I think their list will corroborate what I've got written here in front of me. See, the fours have made it easy. So there you see the queue for qualified. They qualify for the next round. 22 of them, I think, was it? But the eights don't make it. And there's Paul Schockemöller, star of yesteryear with the great Deister, and obviously has an interest in this horse or this rider. Paul has an interest in so many horses and riders, you never know which way he's coming from or going to. Cassio Rivetti goes first for the Ukraine. He's a good horse and a good rider. He was equal 20th this morning after the first round with five faults, which represented, of course, a fence down and a time fault. The time allowed for this is 80 seconds. It was 84 this morning, but there's only 10 numbered obstacles, 13 efforts, whereas this morning there were 12 numbered obstacles with 15 efforts. So they start over the London bus. What better fence to start over? And round to another Oxer fence, the Abbey Road fence. Now the related distance. The planks, a bit better to jump with a pole on top than just the planks. Straight on, short related distance to a very big Oxer, very tall vertical coming out. This is just big and straightforward, but oh, it is big. Now the white fence that caused not that much problems this morning with a no ground line like that. Horses tend to look at the ground and measure it up a bit and try even harder to jump it. That travel combination has just got a bit of a push to it this morning, whereas this morning was a little bit of a hold in the middle. Another looping turn back here to the boat fence. Beautiful fences here, works of art. And now this related distance. That's a huge vertical and four very long strides to another very big and wide Oxer. 78.16. Time doesn't look as if it's going to be too bad actually. Time allowed, as I said, 80 seconds. So four for Cassio Rivetti, plus five is a total of nine. These horses that are carrying five faults, that odd time fault will be expensive. I can't really see that horses that have got four or five faults out of the first round will get a medal. I would rather think that we're going to get at least two or three clears from the existing clears, which will go forward to the jump off, but we'll see. Paul Esterman now for Switzerland with his good, very good Irish sport horse mare. Castlefield Eclipse. First three horses all on five faults. Or penalties, whichever you prefer to call them. Oh, this mare does try. Only a 10-year-old. All the way around Big Ben and the Houses of Parliament. That's another five, so that's 10. He finishes on 10. It's a long, long road through an Olympic Games, because these horses come here a few days before, they settle in, and then they have a warm-up on the one day, which was last Friday, where they jump about, come in the arena, have a feel of the arena, and just get used to the arena, and they can... There's no competition about it. The horses just have a jump round around eight fences at about 140, which are considerably smaller than this. And then there's a preliminary competition. And then two rounds of the team competition, and now two rounds of the individual and a jump off. So these horses are as fit as they make them. But one or two horses will just know they've had enough by the time they get to the end of it. They've got enough petrol in the tank to come out the their end. There's been no tired horses yet, but a fit horse is essential, or a horse like this that runs on its nerves a bit would last the trip a lot better than a lethargic, stuffy sort of horse. Anyway, Rich Fellas, he had five this morning, one down and a time fault, and then we start on with the four faulters. They'll be well aware of the fact that there were only two double clears in Hong Kong, and one of the four faulters finished up getting the medal. Somebody could do that again today, who knows. It's not likely to be Rich Fellas though, because that time fault would be costly. On the other hand, Rich Fellas wouldn't know the meaning of being beaten until he actually is. He's a great competitor, making a great job of this. Good round, very good round, well judged as well, a couple of seconds inside. So he finishes up on five. But there's going to be one or two horses, I think, here that will finish up on four before we even get to the clears. Because we've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine fours. And I should think of those nine, we might well have a couple of clears. And that's a super, super round for Rich Fellas, and Flexible jumped his heart out, as he always does, but it might be all for job satisfaction. And Rich, he says, well, you know, resigned to the fact that he's just jumped a super round, and it's not going to be very productive, other than the fact of great satisfaction, job satisfaction, and having had the great honour of jumping in this wonderful arena, and said that you finished what, 7th, 8th in an Olympic Games, which is not to be sneezed at. Simon Delest, Napoli de Ri. First of the four falters. Of which, as I said, there are nine. Now he's an eight falter. And 4 is 12 total. Nice to see these fences from a ground shot like that. It just gives you a better idea, like that treble combination behind. Look, now you're looking at it from the ground, just how big those fences are when you look from up here. They don't look anywhere near as big, do they? Right, here's a man that's no stranger to this sort of pressure, this sort of occasion, and it is some occasion. Once in 4 years, people program horses over that whole period with the Olympic Games in mind, if the horse is good enough. These fences really are a work of art, aren't they? If the jumping hadn't have been so important, I'd have spent a bit more time describing them. They've all got names, they all represent different places, different venues, different people. That's a big fence in the middle of that treble. And when you see Rodrigo pick the stick up, if you get a bit more oomph to come out of that combination, that treble, you know it's big. He's not one to pick a stick up and give a horse a slap, unless he's he's in dire straits and needs it. Total of 16. He's actually got a time fault. So 17 in total now. Academic anyway. Same part of the world, this time from Mexico, Alberto Mican, Rosalia Lacia, another good mare, 11-year-old Holsteiner by Cassini, Good horse. Bit of a long time-wasting turn around that that bush fences, and that Bob's pushed them out that far to cost them a bit of time, and that's a smashing round, isn't it? He's just inside the time of 80 seconds, and he points to the horse and says it's all him. Well, yes, he, as I said, he is a very good horse and jumping machine, and tries his heart out for the man, but the man rode him very well, didn't he, too? Very good indeed. So, that's our best so far. That's a total of four. Now, if we only get two double clears, he would then be in a jump-off for the bronze. But a long way to go yet. But there's no way he'll be sending him back to the stable just yet. Nice gesture. I love to see people do that, give credit to the horse. They very often do it in racing, and it's not often you see it done in show jumping, but it's a generous gesture, well meant. Alvaro, De Miranda Neto for Brazil. Brazil, Mexico, Brazil. And a Colombian two horses away. Carrying four. To see these horses in this sort of competition starting off with a clean sheet, not carrying faults forward. In some championships it has been done, and you know, when the horse is coming in here carrying about 15 or 17 faults over 3 days and has no chance of a medal or a championship, a lot of the riders are very reluctant to go, understandably, where the horse is out jumping a course like this when they've no chance. But rather like the Mexican who's just had four faults, jumped a clear rather, and he's on a total of four. He's still got a chance of a medal. It's a level playing field when they start here in this competition, and it adds an awful lot to it, I think. Olympics. Another one carrying four. Remarkable 10th Olympics for Ian, and a remarkable achievement for a big fella at the age of 65 to be as fit and active and well and enthusiastic, which he's never been short of that, has Ian? Enthusiastic and all the other bits you need to come here. And full marks on so many counts. And this is a good horse, suits Ian down to the ground. He's big enough and strong enough to carry him. was a lovely, lovely way of just bowling along. He's by that good stallion, Quickstar. Well, that's four. He's looked across at the clock. He knew that he was a bit close to the time. But that's he was inside the time, so that's a total of eight for Ian Miller. Two fours, four in both rounds. Creditable effort. But I fear it won't be good enough to get a medal. Only clear rounds, really, this afternoon here are good enough, particularly if they've got any faults to carry from this morning, from the earlier rounds. Five of the fours gone, four more to come. Well, this young man's gone consistently well all through these games. Never had a bad round. Daniel Blueman. Yet another mare. Only a 9-year-old. What a trier she is. Jumped a super round earlier on for four faults. Bit unlucky, just a little rub there going in, but not much. Himself in glory over these games. He doesn't look too displeased with that. You know, it was a slim chance of a medal anyway, but it'll be 4 days that this young man will remember for the rest of his life, and he won't have many better horses in the rest of his life than that one, however good he gets them or however lucky he is, because she is a star. And she's absolutely tried her heart out for him over every single round of these games. Lovely mare. Now talking about triers. Edwina. Mrs. Topps. Married Jan fairly recently. Ito now, he's born in 1996, 16 years of age. Just folded himself over that in front to miss the poles. Oh, unlucky. Edwina just running round the corner. She doesn't want a time fault. I thought she might have a title as well. 9-4. 13 again. Two clear so far. Alberto Mechan, and of course Rich Fellers. Now the English party, great reception of course, as you'd expect, in his own backyard. The crowd had loads to cheer about on Monday. I don't think we'll ever see the likes of it again in this country. Well, we certainly won't get another Olympic Games in our lifetimes, will we? Britain have had 3 in the last 100 years. The only nation to have done that. And for the British to win on their home soil was, of course, a tremendous occasion here in Greenwich. But that was Monday. Now it's medals to play for again, and there's two men here that have got a good chance, but one more than another. Because Ben Mayer's got 4, he had one down, and the other two British riders have got both on clear, Scott Brash and Nick Skelton. Last and last but 2 to go. In trouble. What a good horse. What a good horse to jump those two oxes, because he backed off that first part. I don't know why. I don't know whether Ben was just a little bit long off it. I'd like to see that again. I might be demeaning him unnecessarily, but whatever happened, the horse backed off it and left himself with an enormous amount to do. But he did it fairly, did it quite easily as well, really. Good round, well judged round for Ben Mayer. So it's 4 there and 4 to carry, total of 8. Another on 8. Ben waves to the crowd, but I'm afraid that he knows that his individual chances have gone now. But he's still gone out in a blaze of glory with a team gold. He would have settled for that before he started, and the horse did back off there, but just shows his ability, how he can jump those two enormous oxes, having had a bit of a setback going in, and only just had that little rub behind, but he had got 4 to carry from earlier on. Now the last of the 4 falters. And then, for sure, I would think where the destination of the 3 medals will lie, with those that are on 1 fault, and of course particularly when we get onto the 6 clears. Talking about that jump off in Hong Kong for the bronze, Mark Hootsager was one of those eight riders. He didn't have an awful lot of choice actually, because his great horse Opium would be more of a Nations Cup horse than a speed horse, and he had no chance against the very quick horses. One of the fastest jump offs I've ever seen, where eight people were going for one medal. Just inside the time. So 4 and 4, he's on 8. And he goes home with the team silver. So, been a good enough games for Mark Hootsager. Now the unlucky quartet come next, the four that actually jumped a clear this morning and just had one time fault, which wasn't difficult to do as the time was tight indeed. It's tight enough this afternoon, but not quite so demanding as it was this morning. This horse of Luciana Dinitz has jumped a smashing round this morning. Lennox. Luciana, mother of twins. This horse is really on song today. Jumping another belter of a round here, isn't he? Oh, she just put a bit of leg on him there to move him forward for whatever reason. I'm gonna ride these with one stirrup. And that's caused her to have that last fence down, having lost that stirrup round the corner. She didn't really have time to get it back, and that's a little bit of a disappointing end for a horse that's jumped his heart out. So, total of 10. Altogether. Just came undone towards the finish of her round. Disappointing really, because he was going so well. So three or four fences from home. And that, if she could have jumped clear, might have just sneaked into a medal position. And this man will be well aware of that. But only a clear round will do now, because this is surely where the medals are going to go. Distributed, one would think, amongst these next nine horses. But how much have they all got left in the tank? Which one's the freshest? Who's got the biggest engine now? He's a very good horse. Now look at the time here. Look how he's picking up a bit of time. This horse has got a little bit of a ponderous way of going. He's literally galloped around there. And I don't have this vertical because of it. And galloping around there, he knows how far it is to these last two fences. Time is going to be tight enough. That is a beautifully judged round, isn't it? 1 second inside the time. Absolutely brilliant judgment there for Herco Schroeder. Clear round, total of one. Now that has got a chance. Now he's got to sit it out and hope the others kick fences down, which no doubt one or two of them will do. Eight horses to go. From his point of view, he's got to have five or six horses have fences down, because he's finished on one. He can't do any worse than that. That's it. Switzerland. Herr Schwitzer. Dear, dear, dear. That's his medal chances gone. One more. This mare's getting tired. One more in the shape of Steve Gerdat. Well done, Piers. Grand mare, that. Total of nine. Just one more now on one time fault, and then we get to the clears. So the best so far. Seven horses to go, but the best so far is Herco Schroeder. Well, there you go. Thank you. the only survivor from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. And what a great games they've had. Third in the team. What a result for them. Great to see. And now one in the final shake-up for the individual as well. Kamal Bahamdan with yet another good mare, an 11-year-old mare by Kumano. Another great trier. But she's just got one time fault from this morning. This mare put some effort into it. Lucky. Long way off. Made it. Made it. Seconds. He's onto a time fault. Oh, but what a creditable round yet again for the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. And a delighted Kamal and the support group there delighted for him, and he has ridden superbly, and that mare has absolutely turned herself inside out. Every single round, whatever approach he's had to a fence, and however strong, she has come up with the goods every single time. She's got a great technique, a great way of doing it, and she tries to leave the poles up. So he's bringing one forward, and he's just had another one, so now he's on two. Now we start the clears. That's the position so far. Erko Schroeder. He knows that it's not likely that four of these guys will have fences down, because he's sitting pretty there on one. But four of them have got to have a fence down. At least four, before he's sure of a medal. We have got four clear so far, albeit one with a time fault. Kieran O'Connor doing absolutely everything he possibly can to keep this little horse off these fences, and the horse is doing his bit. There'll be some punch of the air from Kieran if he jumps these two. And he's made it. And oh, one time fault. 200ths of a second, and the Irish have only just, oh, Robert Splane, I can only guess what he said, and I'm sure he's right. 200ths of a second, one time penalty added to his clear this morning. That puts him on one level with Kirko Schroeder. Two of them now on one fault. Time fault, he says. Time fault. 0.02 seconds. Kieran didn't know, you know. They've only just told him. Oh. So expensive. But it's not over yet. Four to go. Olivier Guillon. Lord de Taze. This horse jumped a belter this morning. Absolute superlative round. Can he do it again? Zero at the moment. The best we've got at the moment of those back in the clubhouse is Kieran O'Connor and Kirko Schroeder, both on one. This horse is back to his very best. Oh. Shouldn't have said that, should I, really? We could have a jump off for a minor medal here this afternoon. Down the order, I'm afraid. He goes down to ninth. Equal ninth. Four of them on nine faults. The clock is playing a big, big part. We've got two on one fault, a two, a four, a five, three on eight, and four nines. And four to go, and four very, very good ones they are. Steve Gerdat for Switzerland, Scott Brash for Great Britain, Marcus Enning for Germany, and last to go, Nick Skelton, Great Britain. Pressure now on these last four riders, because a clear round from, well, if one of them has a fence down, a clear round, they know a clear round here. He's very nearly making them certain of a medal. They surely won't all four go clear. They might, though, because they're four very good horses and they all jumped superb rounds in the first round. And this horse was no exception. He was airborne and he's as fresh as a daisy, look, isn't he? Oof. Ping. This audience has gone absolutely, totally silent just in the last couple of minutes. Oh, Steve, riding for his life. He was in trouble there. Got himself out of it well. He had a bit of a deep stride going in. Gave the horse a lot to do at the next two parts, but the horse did it for him. But with Steve's great help, he's surely clear now. Steady, you've got plenty of time. Up he goes. Now then, and he's inside the time, gallops through the finish. Zero. Our first zero. How many more will we get? If they all go clear, we've got a four-way jump off. If none of them go clear, we've got a winner. And we've also got a silver and a bronze. Because we've got Steve Gerdat on clear. There it is, look. Well, we'd actually have a jump off for one medal there, but anyway, that's hypothetical. We're getting too technical now. Let's watch the others go and then think about the fine print. Let's just enjoy this, because this doesn't need an awful lot of commentary. These horses and riders will do it all for me. We know what they've got to do. Scott Brash, Great Britain. Scott very mindful of the time. Did that just run him into having a front rail off there? Whatever. His medal chances have gone now. Any of these three that have a fence down, their medals have gone. And Gurko Schroeder is sure of a bronze. Well, it's another great round for Scott Brash, but not on today, not quite good enough. Just one fence down, unfortunately. So he's on a total of four, goes into equal fifth place at the moment. And at the moment, Steve Gerdat, he's sure of a medal because he's on clear. He was a bit deep, wasn't he? There, a bit deep, I'm afraid. A bit close. That horse has gone absolutely brilliantly all the way through. That was a bit unlucky. And a disconsolate Scott shakes his head, and I think he's blaming himself a little bit there. Either the horse took him to it or he just had a bit of a deep stride. Scott is so accurate. There's the position. Let's not speculate as to what happens in a minute. We can think about that when the last horse is gone, because this horse and Nick Skelton's horse both jumped superb rounds earlier on. We could have what I'm sure would be Bob Ellis's dream, three double clears, if this one and Big Star reproduce their form of this morning. There's only Nick Skelton now between Steve Gerdat and a gold medal. So he goes down the order. And no prizes for guessing who goes next with that crowd reaction. That's the situation. Steve Gerdat, if Skelly has a fence down, Steve Gerdat wins the gold. And we have a jump off for the bronze and silver. If Nick goes clear, we have a jump off for this gold and silver, and a jump off for the bronze. Man with a nation behind him. Time fault, Nick. Now, picking up time round there. He's a long striding horse. He should be okay. Three fences. A time to pick to have a fence down, an innocuous fence like that, with all the trouble jumped and all the preparation and the whole season programmed. Skelly's face says it all, and he said, well, you don't need me to describe it, do you? We all know everybody's feelings and Nick's feelings. That's well, one more time Nick Skelton goes right to the wire in an Olympic Games and comes away empty-handed. Oh, well, but one man's grief is another man's joy. And there is the gold medal winner, Steve Gerdat of Switzerland, takes the gold on that brilliant horse. He deserved it, the way the horse has gone this afternoon. He's outjumped everything. The horse was absolutely doing handsprings in the first round earlier on. He's gone like that all the way through. He always had the potential to win a gold medal, that horse, or to do something of the very highest order, because he is such a star performer. He wouldn't be the easiest, but he's got better and better and better. And a very disconsolate Nick Skelton walks away. Team gold, though, not going away empty-handed, but that is one hugely, hugely disappointed man, knowing what a chance he'd got with a superstar horse, and a mistake at the very final hurdle. And there's Steve's father, Philippe, the chef de keep of the Belgian team, getting congratulations all the way around. And you'd have to say, fair play, justice was done. The man is always been a very, very good jockey, with Jalisco de Solier and lots more horses. He's still only 30. You'd think he was 40 the amount of time that he's been around at the very highest level. And he's won World Cups, he's won major championships all over the world, and a mainstay of Nations Cups and championship teams for Switzerland for quite a long time now. And now he's got the reward that, on the day, he deserved that. The way he's ridden and the way the horse jumped, certainly the horse deserved it. We've seen some fantastic riding performances. But That horse was absolutely on song today. Unbelievable. He was magic and thoroughly deserved to win it. He's jumped arguably the best of any horse. You know, it, probably that's overstating it a little bit, because there's about half a dozen other horses that have jumped perhaps as spectacularly and just had an odd fence down or a time penalty. But, you know, you could take nothing away from Steve Gerdat and the horse. The rest didn't lose it. They won it. So, let's have a look at the score sheet in all that excitement. We've got the gold medal winner, but we've got two on one fault. So, I'm sure that they will be jumping off for the silver and bronze. Kieran O'Connor, when he came in here, he would have settled for a... I'm sure he would have settled for a medal of some sort. And he has ridden absolutely brilliantly in hands-on fashion. And there it is, Herka Schroeder. Kieran O'Connor's horse will be faster, there's no doubt about that. I would think, you know, sticking my neck out, making predictions like that, but he's a quick horse across the ground. He's a horse that's was brought out and ridden to quite a good level by Nina Broughton, a Scandinavian rider. A very good rider too, but Kieran O'Connor picked it up and run with it, and Kieran has actually ridden out of his skin today to get that little horse to perform like he has done, because he's a good horse, make no mistake, but my goodness, Kieran at this level, he's as good as anybody. He's done it in Athens and he can do it again. A nice feeling for these two riders, because they're both sure of a medal, sure they'd like to win the silver. But the bronze would do for either of them, but you try telling them that now. The facilities here in Greenwich are absolutely fantastic, as you can see. These horses won't want an awful lot out there. They've done enough jumping. They just want a little prop or two, and keep the muscles warm and keep the horses alert and on the job. They wouldn't want to go and have the first fence down. But as you can see, there's about three or four different, well, there's a lot more than that actually, at this gel track arena. And one undercover there under the tent. It'll all be dismantled and taken down after the games are all over on Sunday. And a little bit more jumping here at the weekend actually, which is the riding section of the modern pentathlon, which I believe are the last medals of the games. That's Saturday and Sunday. I'll be pleased to be doing a bit of commentary and watching that, because those five disciplines very demanding, as this jump off is going to be between these two guys here. They jump fences, let's have a look now. Two and three, well, two, it's quite a straightforward jump off course actually. Two, three, four, A, B, five, six, and seven. And then after seven, instead of turning back to that vertical that they've just been doing, the one Nick Skelton had, they go back to fence one. And then miss out nine and gallop all the way up the arena to fence 10. The last fence, that big oxer that we've just seen. So it's two, it's pretty well the same course, you know, the guts of it is anyway. Two, three, four, A, B, five, six, seven, B, just the middle part of the combination, that big oxer over the water. And then back to fence one, turn sharp right hand down, a time-saving turn there, and then straight on, a long gallop all up the arena to fence 10. The draw will play a big part here, always does, but it's even more a part here, because rather like when Rolf Göran Bengtsson jumped off with Eric Lamaze in Hong Kong for the gold and silver, and Rolf had to go first with Ninja, and good a horse as Ninja was, with the benefit of knowing what he'd got to do, Eric Lamaze was always going to be faster. And the same thing happened in the jump off, the 8-horse jump off for the bronze, which was won by Beasy Madden. Well, we didn't get the rain that was predicted this morning. That's a good thing. Another 3 minutes. I know that we're talking to people in different time zones around the world, but it's 4 o'clock British summer time here in London. See, it's interesting really that Herco has got to go first. Because he's going to have to set fire to him here a little bit, but he wouldn't be the fastest horse. He wouldn't be as fast a horse, as I've said, as fast as Kieran O'Connor's horse, Blue Lloyd. So he's going to have to do something remarkable. Just how fast does he go, you know, because Kieran's horse hasn't, in fairness, looked like having a fence down today. The man's riding out of his skin and looks capable of doing anything. But I think he's going to have to go fast enough and hope that he leaves the fences up. Here's the animation. The old fence two. The first fence was down the left-hand corner to start with in the previous round, but then fence three, four, and then back to this big oxer over there. These little toy fences are not very big, are they, but they're mighty fences in there. The white fence across the arena, the middle part of the treble combination, and then back to the old first fence, and then straight up to miss out fence nine, and straight on to the at big oxer. Well, Kieran O'Connor can't win the gold, but he'll go some way this afternoon to making amends for having lost the gold medal on a disqualification, which was very unfortunate for him. But 8 years ago now, in Athens. But a silver or bronze medal would do very nicely, I would think, for him. No Irish team here, just two top-class individuals in Kieran O'Connor and Billy Toomey. Billy went well, but just had an odd fence down that he could have done without, so hasn't quite made the cut through to today. So, come on, Kirko, you must know where you're going now. He's obviously trying to think. Rob Aaron's still spelling it out for him, but it's not a difficult jump, of course. Not difficult to follow at all. How fast is he going to go? Good luck to both of them. They're both sure of a medal. They've provided us with some wonderful jumping. Let's just enjoy this jump off for the silver and bronze. But whoever you are and wherever you are, you won't enjoy this jump off as much as Steve Gerdat, because he's already got the gold. Got to go all the way around there. It's a long way. flimsy fence up the gallop, jumps it well. This horse does try. Back over the bus and gallop to the last. That's a very good round indeed for Gurko. 49.79. Superb round. And that's given Kieran O'Connor quite a lot to do, because he was very quick to the second fence. He was very quick gallop to the last. And while I'm saying that Kieran O'Connor's horse would be a naturally quicker horse than that, that little fella, he's a formidable pilot. And I think he's done absolutely everything he possibly can now to force Kieran O'Connor from Ireland into making a mistake. Because Kieran knows he can't hang about. And the most important thing as well, of course, Herco was clear. He's got to leave everything up, and he's got to be faster than 49.79. Faster, isn't he? Can he leave him up? He's jumped his trouble. He shouldn't have one of these down, really. He's miles in front. Steady, Kieran. Don't blow it. Oh! Why? Well, a broad smile, he accepts it, and it's silver for the Netherlands, bronze for Ireland, but gold for Switzerland. So the medal presentation now, and a jubilant, although he's just lost the silver medal, a jubilant Kieran O'Connor. He's ridden very well indeed this afternoon. He would not have been one of the favourites here. He's always a good competitor, obviously, you know, at the top of the tree. But he wouldn't have started as one of the favourites. So to come away with a bronze medal is great credit to him. Lucas Schroeder, one of three brothers, all very talented riders. He's not very tall, but he's all action. And he's like one of many great riders that has done it on so many horses, on different horses. He just doesn't shine on one particularly good horse. He can ride them all, and at the very highest level as well. He was very unlucky. This is a great reward for him, because unlucky last year in the European Championships, he led going into the last day. But the first major championship medal for Steve Gerd out of Switzerland. And as I said earlier on, thoroughly deserved on the day. He went out there and he won that. Absolutely delighted, Steve Gerdat. The national anthem of Switzerland.
S'il vous plaît, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national de la Suisse.
Please stand for the national anthem of Switzerland.
Thank you.